put it here because I'm not Shlomo Arzi or something like that. Yeah. Okay, so a few words about myself. Those who don't know me, I'm working in a lot of technologies of open source, Python, Java, and other stuff. I'm working at Sela, as you can see from my shirt. In the last 9 years, I'm working as a lecturer and consulting in a very vast areas, mainly in open source technologies. But recently, I'm also technically leading the Google Cloud partnership in Sela, helping other companies moving to Google Cloud. And this lecture will also be talk about one of the technologies, one of the services that Google Cloud offered. So we will start talking about the data streaming world today, data processing, and we will talk about what is Apache Beam. And then we will move forward to talk about the different components of Apache Beam, and we will talk about how it's got to do with Google Cloud Dataflow. And then we will move to Apache Beam programming model. We will talk about pipelines, collections, transformers, and source and sync. And of course, the most important part of the lecture, we will see a demo, and we will move on the code in Python. Actually, only recently, Google Cloud, the Dataflow, and Apache Beam supports the Python SDK for Apache Beam. So it's something that really happened in last January. I think it's very useful to talk. It's very early stages of the product itself. So I think it's very important that all of you try it, try to contribute it, whether to test it or whether to work with it, because I think it's very important framework. So let's begin. So today, when we talk about data processing, there are a lot of tools. There are jokes that say that if you are not happy with the data processing framework that you have, just wait a few days and another data processing framework will show. You can see Spark, Pig, Flume, Airflow, all kinds of runners, all kinds of data processing frameworks that you can use. And usually all of them running on HDFS or any other distributed file system, whether it's S3 or Google Cloud Storage or traditionally NFS. And the idea of Apache Beam is try to create a unified API for all kinds of runners that you can use the same code to running your code in Dataflow or in Spark or in Flume or any other framework that you like, and your code will be the same. So you will have the storage layer that there we have some kinds of unified API, we have some kinds of technologies that are related to everything, and it's pretty much standards. And the idea is that you will use any kind of runner that you want, those that specialize in streaming, those that specialize in batch data processing or any other, but your code will be the same working with Apache Beam. Of course, every runner will have its own adapter to adapt the code of Apache Beam. So this will be very great because first of all, you have one API that you can learn, and then I myself, that working in lecturing many courses, will lose a lot of jobs because now I can't teach Spark and Flume and all kinds of technology. I need to only teach Apache Beam, but I have a lucky it's still in early stages. But the most important thing is that I can just replace my data processing framework and choose another one and doesn't need to rewrite my code, and this is really great. And it also will help me move from on-premise to the cloud or vice versa, because now I can write use the direct runner, in a few seconds we will see it, we can use the direct runner and run things on premise, and using other runners that are usually working in the cloud, like Google Cloud Dataflow or any others, and my code will be the same and the logic will be the same. And the whole initiative of the Apache Beams comes from Google that has an agenda that all the services that's provided by Google Cloud Platform will be available on any other clouds or on-premise, which means every technology that appears in Google Cloud will be also available as open source. So Google is the real sponsor of Apache Beam, and it's of course helping the community, helping the development of this framework. So if you are not happy with Google Cloud Dataflow, which is actually the runner, the first runner, which is the reference implementations that Apache Beam is working with, you can also take your code from Google Cloud, move it to another place like Amazon, AWS, or Azure, and run it on Spark, or Flume, or any other technologies, and it will work seamlessly. So it's actually a standardization of the data processing frameworks, and this is the actual goal of Apache Beam. And with the power of Google, they are take Cloudera and Data Artisan to this mission, and we all work together to make Apache Beam a great technology. So before we move into the code, let's, before that, or the data models, let's understand what Apache Beam provides us. So it provides the four W's, what results are calculated, which actions I want to do, whether I want to do sums, joins, histogram, machine learnings, and stuff like that, which is the actually a calculation itself, where in the event time are results calculated, which actually means timing and windowing in case of streaming. Windows, sessions, single global window, batch operations, stuff like that. When in processing time as our result materials, all kinds of triggers that we can pull the data from that, whether it's event triggered from some kinds of queuing or from files or from other kinds of sources, and how the refinements of results relates. This is usually transformers, actions that are more related to optimize the code and make it more available. You can see all the, so you can see the actions, you can see that you have a parallel do, group by key, flatten, combine, composite transform, side input, source API, metrics. This is all kinds of actions you can do with the what, and when is referred to the windowing. As you can see, global windows, fixed windows, sliding windows, etc. Here you can see a matrix of all the things that are supported in all kinds of runner. We have the B model, and we have the Google Cloud Dataflow, and that I will talk about it in a few seconds. We have the Flink, Spark, Apex, and Gear Pump, which is very new technology. And also here you can see which kinds of trigger I can support, configurable triggering, event time triggers, processing time triggers, and etc. And in the how data, how do refinements relate, we have discarding and accumulating. So this is the metrics that we talk about. Okay, let's move on to Google Cloud Dataflow. So Google Cloud Dataflow is actually a service in the cloud of Google that you can write code in Java or now also in Python that fit to Apache Beam and performing your data processing in the cloud. It's practically the ETL tool for Google Cloud Platform. Every data they need to move from one place to another, Google Cloud Dataflow, it's a great place to do it. And it's a serverless technology. You don't need to define any servers. Google Cloud just spin up the instances for you. You're just paying for the CPU time that you are used. And you have automatic scaling to up to 1,024 core automatically, and this thing's going to be also growing. And you have also connectors for all the types, all the data source types of Google Cloud. BigQuery, data store, PubSub, all kinds of technology. And it's really great technology. You just run up your code and this is it. You don't need to define anything. You don't need to spin up servers to maintenance them or stuff like that. And it's really cool technology. And in a few minutes, when we see the demo, we'll see how the dashboard of Google Cloud Dataflow would look like. Okay, so actually, it looks like something like that. When I'm running the code, I will get a screen like that. Each one of the, all of you probably knows that if you are working with the data processing frameworks, each actually a graph, a direct attached graph, a DAG. So every component here do something. We will talk about it in a few seconds. And this is what the dashboard of Google Cloud Dataflow looks like. Of course, in the future, you will be able to drag and drop components here and configure them from the UI. But right now, it's just a dashboard that provides for all components how much time it takes. And all kinds of data that you need to get. So this is how it looks like, and this is how it will look like when we run off the code. So as I said, we have, let's talk about the programming model of Apache Beam, which is actually, as I said before, it's a graph. So it includes a pipeline, P collections, transformer, and source and sink. The idea is that we are starting with the source, we will end in the sink, and in the middle we have transformers that holding the P collections. Okay, so actually when we try to write some code in Apache Beam, and we'll see it in few minutes, we're actually writing a pipeline. Pipeline is configured, and we're adding a transformer to it to get our code done. And we have a lot of options. One of the options is which runner I can use to run my code. So I can write pipeline and decided to run it on Google Cloud Dataflow or direct runner to test it on my local computer or any other runner that I choose. And basic model, the programming model of Apache Beam is very similar to Spark if you are working with Spark. Like Spark that we have RDD or data frame, we here have a P collections, which is data that is stretched out to all the nodes in the cluster that performing the data processing. And the P collection is immutable, so every time that you are changing the data itself, it creates another P collections, and it cannot be shared with by any other pipeline, so it's thread safe. It's usually more thread safe than other technologies, and you can work with P collection as bounded, as batch, or you can perform windowing and decided to work it as a stream. And peak collections are encoded, and the Apache Beam provides default encoding for the data that we are working with. Okay, let's move forward. Transformers are the main components that you can actually analyze your data, working on your data. We have all kinds of transformers. I will try to move as fast as I can to see the code. We have parallel do, we have group by, we have combining, we have shuffling, flattening the data, and all kinds of actions that very similar to stuff in Spark or something like that. And we have source and sink. Source is the entrance point of the pipeline, and sink is the output point. And we have all kinds of connectors, and you can also write your customized code for MongoDB, Couchbase, Cassandra, etc. Okay, let's see the demo. This is the most important part. Let's see some code. Okay, so here I'm using a tool called CloudShell. It's some kinds of VM that provides to any user in Google Cloud. Inside that, I downloaded a Git example from the training materials of Google Cloud. I'm an instructor certified of Google, so I have an access. But it's also in GitHub, so you can also take the code from there. I'm doing import to Apache Beam and to argparse to passing the variables here. And this is start with just checking, parsing the lines. This is an example of getting a code in Java and looking how much imports we have in all the files that we do. So what we have here is all kinds of helping methods, split package name, that split the package name here. And we have also get packages, getting all the packages name from the file. And we have package use when we are performing imports. So I do package use and find it, and getting all the values that I need here. So actually, this is not very interesting. It's just code that parsing files. Here is the code that getting the parameters that we want, the output prefix, the input. The rest of the arguments are taken here.
What's the entry point?
I will run this script, okay? And this is the code that will be executed, okay? First, I'm taking the arguments, okay? The description, where should I put the output for the all the data that I need, the input, and the runner. Here is the code taking the runners. In a few minutes, I will show you how the which arguments that I'm sending to the code. And this is the most important part. I'm defining a pipeline. This is this line, yeah. Taking the pipeline here. Oh, never mind.
This one.
Okay.
The
okay. One. I'm creating the pipeline. I defining the input, the output, and the keyword import. This is the word that I'm looking for. And now I'm taking the pipeline and performing end to taking all the transformer that I profile, that I'm performing. I'm put the transformer name, first of all, get Java, and get it, read it from the text. This is the input that I'm getting the data from. The package, the get imports, running and taking all the imports from the data. The package use moving all the files and looking for the get imports. And this is the summary of all the data, taking the file and writing to the file. And in the end of that, I'm performing the run and running it on the runner. Okay? So now let's look how it looks, how I can run it, and we will see the results on Google Cloud Dataflow. So here is how I run it. I run the Python is popular, giving the project name, now giving the job name, and I put from Google Cloud Storage, putting the staging area, the temp, and the output, and of course, taking the runner, Dataflow pipeline runner, and if I want, I can provide the SDK location, the SDK of the Google Cloud Dataflow that should be run as well. Now, I will not run it because I don't have enough time, but let's look in the Google Cloud dashboard to see the result. It will take less than 1 minute. Okay, so this is something that I ran yesterday in the evening, getting, no, this is not the one. This one. Okay, so, sorry. Let me find it. Something that I ran. Yeah, maybe here. Okay. Okay, getting the Java code to HashMap and looking for the is popular and combining all the data and writing to a file that we are working with. Okay, and in addition, we can see here the dashboard, how many workers work, and all the configuration. Since I don't have enough time to get inside more than that, I would like to thank you for listening, and if you have questions, this is a great time to do it right now. Thank you very much.